Hello, my brothers and sisters.
Hello.
I miss you so much, and it is wonderful that we are gathered here together as a parish family. So let us open our hearts as we celebrate this Pentecost Sunday. Let us offer to our loving Father all our prayers and petitions. As we pray for ourselves, for our families, our friends, for all those who are sick or suffering, all those who need our prayers today. With faith, let us talk to God. And we gather in the name of the Father, and of the Son, and of the Holy Spirit. Amen. The grace of our Lord Jesus Christ, and the love of God, and the communion of the Holy Spirit be with you all.
Amen.
My brothers and sisters, before we continue our celebration, let us call to mind our sins, and let us ask our loving Father to make us worthy of these holy mysteries.
Lord Jesus, you were sent to heal the contrite of heart. Lord, have mercy.
Lord, have mercy.
Lord Jesus, you came to call sinners. Christ, have mercy.
Christ, have mercy.
Lord Jesus, you are seated at the right hand of the Father and intercede for us. Lord, have mercy.
Lord, have mercy.
May Almighty God have mercy on us, forgive us all our sins, and bring us to everlasting life.
Amen.
And now, full of joy, let us give glory to our Father. Glory to God in the highest, and on earth peace to people of good will. We praise you, we bless you, we adore you, we glorify you, we give you thanks for your great glory. Lord God, Heavenly King, O God, Almighty Father, Lord Jesus Christ, only begotten Son, Lord God, Lamb of God, Son of the Father, you take away the sins of the world. Have mercy on us. You take away the sins of the world. Receive our prayer. You are seated at the right hand of the Father. Have mercy on us. For you alone are the Holy One. You alone are the Lord. You alone are the Most High, Jesus Christ, with the Holy Spirit, in the glory of God the Father. Amen. Let us pray. O God, who by the mystery of today's great feast sanctify your whole church in every people and nation, pour out, we pray, the gifts of the Holy Spirit across the face of the earth, and with the divine grace that was at work when the gospel was first proclaimed, fill now once more the hearts of this family. Through our Lord Jesus Christ, your Son, who lives and reigns with you in the unity of the Holy Spirit, one God, forever and ever.
Amen.
A reading from the Acts of the Apostles. When the time for Pentecost was fulfilled, they were all in one place together, and suddenly there came from the sky a noise like a strong driving wind, and it filled the entire house in which they were. Then there appeared to them tongues as of fire, which parted and came to rest on each one of them. And they were all filled with the Holy Spirit and began to speak in different tongues as the Spirit enabled them to proclaim. Now there were devout Jews from every nation under heaven staying in Jerusalem. At this sound, they gathered in a large crowd, but they were confused because each one heard them speaking in his own language. They were astonished, and in amazement they asked, "Are not all of these people who are speaking Galileans? Then how does each of us hear them in his native language? We are Parthians, Medes, Elamites, inhabitants of Mesopotamia, Judea, and Cappadocia, Pontus and Asia, Phrygia and Pamphylia, Egypt and the districts of Libya near Cyrene, as well as travelers from Rome, both Jews and converts to Judaism, Cretans and Arabs. Yet we hear them speaking in our own tongues of the mighty acts of God." The word of the Lord.
Thanks be to God.
Our responsorial song, "Lord, send out your spirit and renew the face of the earth."
Lord, send out your spirit and renew the face of the earth.
Bless the Lord, O my soul. O Lord, my God, you are great indeed. How manifold are your works, O Lord. The earth is full of your creatures.
Lord, send out your spirit and renew the face of the earth.
May the glory of the Lord endure forever. May the Lord be glad in his works. Pleasing to him be my theme. I will be glad in the Lord. Lord, send out your spirit and renew the face of the earth. If you take away their breath, they perish and return to their dust. When you send forth your spirit, they are created, and you renew the face of the earth. Lord, send out your spirit and renew the face of the earth. The second reading is a reading from the first letter of St. Paul to the Corinthians. Brothers and sisters, no one can say, "Jesus is Lord," except by the Holy Spirit. There are different kinds of spiritual gifts, but the same Spirit. There are different forms of service, but the same Lord. There are different workings, but the same God, who produces all of them in everyone. To each individual, the manifestation of the Spirit is given for some benefit. As a body, one is though its many parts, and all the parts of the body, though many, are one body, so also Christ. For one in spirit, we were all baptized into one body, whether Jews or Greeks, slaves or free persons, and we were all given to drink of the one Spirit. The word of the Lord.
Thanks be to God.
Amen. When the doors were locked, where the disciples were, for fear of the Jews, Jesus came and stood in their midst and said to them, "Peace be with you." When he had said this, he showed them his hands and his side. The disciples rejoiced when they saw the Lord. Jesus said to them again, "Peace be with you. As the Father has sent me, so I send you." And when he had said this, he breathed on them and said to them, "Receive the Holy Spirit. Whose sins you forgive are forgiven them, and whose sins you retain are retained." The Gospel of the Lord.
Before I enter into my reflection, I just want to take the time to remind you about a couple of rules we need to keep in mind. You know, I don't know if you saw the video I posted this week, but I want to remind you, if probably you didn't see the video, just a few things we need to be aware of. First of all, as you noticed, our singing has been reduced. You know, it's a matter of not speaking, or you know, not because when we sing it's louder, our voices are louder, so they are we are asked to reduce our singing. Also, the collection will be taken at the entrances of the door, so there is not going to be anybody passing through the pews collecting any money. So we have the basket here, and if you forget, there is another one in the back of the church in your way out. So thank you so much for your generosity. For communion, that is the most important part, I think. For communion, I will be the only one distributing Holy Communion. I will be also wearing my mask when the time comes, and the container with Holy Communion will be always covered up on the altar and over here on the table, so I will have contact with Holy Communion. Also, the ushers will guide you as we come forward to receive Holy Communion, always keeping 6 foot distance as we are required. One pew at a time and alternating sides. So the usher will help you with that. Also, we ask you to use your hand sanitizer before coming to receive Holy Communion. If you didn't bring one, the usher will have one provided for you. So no worries, but be encouraged, you know, from the time on to bring your own hand sanitizer. So I ask you, when you approach at the moment to receive Holy Communion, put down your mask, extend your hands. I will put the Holy Communion in your hands. Receive Holy Communion, put your mask back, and then proceed to your seat. Does it make sense?
Yeah.
Yes. Okay. Very good, very good. So thank you so much for your understanding. The way to leave the church at the end of Mass will be through the front main doors, unless you need the elevator. Well, but we ask everybody to exit the church through the main doors. But if you need the elevator, no worries, you can wait and use the elevator. I ask you to please avoid congregating or conversation at the end of Mass, especially when other people are waiting to leave the church. And also we need to start cleaning very well the church for tomorrow, for the next Mass. Few other reminders is that the 11:30 a.m. Mass has been transferred to 12 noon because that will give us time to properly clean the church before the Mass. So 11:30 a.m. Mass on Sundays is transferred to 12 noon. We will resume also our daily Mass schedule at 7:30 a.m. Monday through Thursday. So if you are able to join us during the week, welcome to do so Monday through Thursday, 7:30 a.m. Confessions. Confessions will be available only on Tuesdays, in the morning and in the afternoon, 9 a.m. to 10 a.m. and 6 p.m. to 7 p.m. So I will be here in the side of the chapel. Everybody's welcome to join us for confession as well, Tuesdays, mornings, and afternoons. We are also in need of volunteers, people who are willing to help us, like Mike did in the beginning and Beth at the entrance, you know, guiding people, asking them where to sit, and you know, just helping others to feel comfortable and to have a good experience coming into our church. So if you are interested, please call us at the office and Beth will help you. Thank you so much. And finally, please, if you have any concerns, you have questions or suggestions, please do not hesitate to reach out. Call me, or you can send me an email as well to my email, fathercarlosruiz@gmail.com, because the former parish email is not working anymore, so you can use my own, and I will be willing to answer to you and to talk to you. So please don't hesitate to reach out anytime you have any concern or any question. I am here for you, to help you, and to listen to you as well. So thank you so much. I want to take also the opportunity to give thanks to our parish staff for the wonderful work during this time. All of this has been possible because of them. Mike, our custodian, Kristen, who cleans our church, Perry Carroll, who helps also during the week, and Donna and Beth in our parish office. They have been a wonderful, wonderful help, and all of this is possible because they are here for us as well. So thank you so much to all of them, and thanks to all of you for your wonderful support, your company, and all your prayers. God bless you all. I can say with all confidence that we have a great parish family. We are a wonderful parish family, so thank you so much. Thank you, everybody. Today we celebrate the birth of the Church, the day in which all the apostles and disciples, together with Mary as well, received the courage, the vitality, the power to go out, to get rid of their fear and preach, proclaim widely the good news of love and forgiveness Jesus taught them. The Gospel of John tells us that all the apostles were together in a little room because they were afraid. They had fear of the Jews because they were persecuted, so they were so afraid. But Jesus appeared to them and he said to them, "Receive the Holy Spirit." I just want to imagine that beautiful moment in which the apostles were afraid, they were conversing with each other, and they were saying, "What are we going to do? What are we going to do? We cannot go out. They're going to kill us. What do we do?" And then Jesus appears and says to them, "Do not worry. Receive the Holy Spirit. Calm down. Do not worry. Receive my strength, my capacity. Get rid of that fear and go out and proclaim the good news." With these words, the disciples experience the outpouring of new strength and all graces. We, you and I, like the disciples, receive the Spirit of Jesus. We receive the Holy Spirit who inflames our hearts and makes our souls burned with courage to stand and and say to one another, I am a believer. I believe in Jesus. I love Jesus. And for that reason, I continue praying. For that reason, I know that Jesus is more powerful than anything else. Many weeks during this time of COVID-19, we have been afraid. In the midst of the uncertainties, obstacles, difficulties, contradictory thoughts and forces, we know we were like the apostles, so to speak, behind locked doors, afraid of the outside, afraid of others, because we didn't know what was going to happen. So we were afraid. During this time of pandemic, we can see the action of the Holy Spirit. This is a moment for all of us, for evangelization. It is a moment to encounter, a moment to dialogue, of understanding, accomplishment, a moment in which we know that the Holy Spirit acts in mysterious ways, and especially during difficult times. Last week, I had a conversation, a virtual meeting with our 8th graders, 13 of them. We had a nice chat for a little bit, half hour. I wanted to know how they were doing, how studies were going, so I wanted to talk to them. So we had a nice conversation for a half hour. And then I asked them, could you tell me please one thing you have learned during this difficult time, during the time you have been at home? Tell me one thing you have learned during this time of the pandemic. And all of them agreed about one thing: family. Family. They said to me, Father, we have learned how to love more our families, how to understand each other. Now I know better my sister or my brother. I know my mom very well. I don't know if that is good or bad, but they said to me that now I know them very well. I know them and I love them. And I don't know what to do without them now. Family. What a beautiful thing. They said, Father, also, we have been praying together as a family. Few things we didn't do before very often. Now we enjoy them. What a beautiful thing. You see, the Holy Spirit recreates. The Holy Spirit brings beautiful, wonderful things out of darkness. That is the power of God. That is the power of the Lord, who brings us what we truly need in the moment we need it the most. So this is a new beginning for all of us, yes. For all of us here gathered together, and all those who are still at home waiting to join us, this is a new opportunity. We pray for those who are still at home for different circumstances, and we know they pray for us. We are one family, learning how to love and to take care of one another more and more, especially during difficult times. We are here for one another, supporting and making sure that everybody is safe. My brothers and sisters, let us hear how the Holy Spirit acts in all of us and through us. He is present in our church more than ever. He is with us. The Holy Spirit is present, guiding us, helping us, to take care of one another out of love. This is the birth of the church. This is a new beginning for all of us as a parish family. So together we say, come, Holy Spirit, come. O most blessed light, divine, shine within these hearts of yours. Heal our wounds. Our strength renew. Give us your salvation. Give us joy that never ends. Come, Holy Spirit, come. Saint Anna, Mother of Mary, pray for us.
Together, my brothers and sisters, let us profess our faith. I believe in one God, the Father Almighty, maker of heaven and earth, of all things visible and invisible. I believe in one Lord, Jesus Christ, the only begotten Son of God, born of the Father before all ages, God, light from light, true God from true God, begotten, not made, consubstantial with the Father. Through him all things were made. For us men and for our salvation, he came down from heaven, and by the Holy Spirit was incarnate of the Virgin Mary and became man. For our sake, he was crucified under Pontius Pilate. He suffered death and was buried, and rose again on the third day in accordance with the Scriptures. He ascended into heaven and is seated at the right hand of the Father. He will come again in glory to judge the living and the dead, and his kingdom will have no end. I believe in the Holy Spirit, the Lord, the giver of life, who proceeds from the Father and the Son, who with the Father and the Son is adored and glorified, who has spoken through the prophets. I believe in one holy Catholic and Apostolic Church. I confess one baptism for the forgiveness of sins, and I look forward to the resurrection of the dead and the life of the world to come. Amen. Inspired by the Holy Spirit, let us offer to our loving Father all our prayers and petitions.
Our response is, Lord, hear our prayer. For all who have been signed and sealed with the Holy Spirit, that this church may be united as one body made of many parts, we pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
For the peoples of the world who do not know God, that the Spirit of truth proclaimed to every nation may indeed renew the face of the earth, we pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
For the outpouring of the Spirit of peace, that men and women may know the forgiveness of their sins, we pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
For this community gathered by God, that the Spirit who makes holy our Eucharistic gifts may strengthen and refresh us, we pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
For ordinations and vocations to the priesthood and the consecrated life, both here in the Diocese of Worcester and throughout the world, we pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
For our sick, those affected by the coronavirus, for Deacon Jim, Jacob the Carolus, Mary Eddy, and Anselma Geronimo, for our bereaved and our recently deceased, Dot Proyani, we pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
For Saint Anne the School, Saint Anne the Parish, and for the intentions placed at the feet of Saint Anne, our patroness, and those held in the silence of our hearts. We pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
And in a special way, we pray for the victims of the COVID-19 virus, for whom this Mass is being offered. We pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer. And together let us call upon the intercession of our Mother Mary, she who was there with the apostles and received the Holy Spirit. May she protect us and bless us, and help us to know that God is with us at all times. Hail Mary, full of grace, the Lord is with thee. Blessed art thou among women, and blessed is the fruit of thy womb, Jesus. Holy Mary, Mother of God, pray for us sinners, now and at the hour of our death. Amen.
Blessed are you, Lord God of all creation, for through goodness we have received the one we offer you, fruit of the vine, a work of human hands. You will become our spiritual drink.
Lord, wash away my iniquity, cleanse me from all my sins.
Pray, my brothers and sisters, that my sacrifice and yours may be acceptable to God, the Almighty Father.
May the Lord accept the sacrifice of your hands for the praise of the Lord and his name, for honor and glory of all his holy church.
Amen. Grant, we pray, O Lord, that, as promised by your Son, the Holy Spirit may reveal to all of us more abundantly the hidden mystery of this sacrifice, and graciously lead us into all that is truth. We pray through Christ our Lord.
Amen.
The Lord be with you.
And with your spirit.
Lift up your hearts. Let us give thanks to the Lord our God.
It is
truly right and just, our duty and our salvation, always and everywhere to give you thanks, Lord, Holy Father, Almighty and Eternal God. For bringing your Paschal mystery to completion, you bestowed the Holy Spirit today on those you made your adopted children by anointing them to your only begotten Son. This same Spirit, as the Church came to birth, opened to all peoples the knowledge of God, and brought together the many languages of the earth in profession of the one faith. And so, with all the angels and saints, we praise you, as without end we proclaim. In a similar way, when supper was ended, he took the chalice, and once more giving thanks, he gave the chalice to his disciples, saying, "Take this, all of you, and drink from it, for this is the chalice of my blood, the blood of the new and eternal covenant, which will be poured out for you and for many, for the forgiveness of sins. Do this in memory of me. Brothers and sisters, this is the mystery of our faith. Remember, Lord, your family spread throughout the world and bring her to the fullness of healing and charity, together with Francis, our Pope, Robert, our Bishop, all your priests, deacons, and religious. Remember also our brothers and sisters who have fallen asleep in the hope of the resurrection and all who have died in your mercy. Let us remember our beloved ones who have gone before us. We remember especially all the victims of COVID-19. Welcome them, O Lord, into the light of your face. Have mercy on us all, we pray that, with the Blessed Virgin Mary, Mother of God, Saint Joseph, her beloved husband, and all the saints, Saint Anna, who have blessed you throughout the ages, we may merit to be co-heirs to eternal life, and may praise and glorify you through your Son, Jesus Christ. Through him and with him and in him, O God, Almighty Father, in the unity of the Holy Spirit, all glory and honor is yours, forever and ever. Savior, Jesus Christ, for the kingdom, the power, and the glory are yours, now and forever. Lord Jesus Christ, who said to your apostles, "Peace I leave you, my peace I give you," look not on our sins, but on our faith, and graciously grant us all peace and healing in accordance with your will, who live and reign forever and ever. Amen. The peace of the Lord be with you always. Jesus Christ. You bring me to judgment and condemnation, but through your loving mercy, before me protection in mind and body, and a healing remedy for me and my family. Behold Jesus, who takes away the sins of the world. Blessed are those called to the supper of the Lamb. Lord, I am no worthy that you should enter under my roof, but only say the word, and my soul shall be healed. May the body and blood of Christ keep us safe for eternal life.
all to join me praying the beautiful prayer of spiritual communion. My Jesus, I believe that you are present in the most holy sacrament. I love you above all things, and I desire to receive you into my soul. Since I cannot at this moment receive you sacramentally, come at least spiritually into my heart. I embrace you as if you were already there, and unite myself wholly to you. Never permit me to be separated from you. Amen. Let us pray. O God, who bestow heavenly gifts upon your church, safeguard, we pray, the grace you have given, that the gift of the Holy Spirit poured out upon her may retain all its force, and that this spiritual food may gain her abundance of eternal redemption. We pray through Christ our Lord.
Amen.
Amen. Well, you did a wonderful job, let me tell you. Thank you so much. We were so afraid, you know, what was going to happen, how people were going to, you know, react to all these regulations, but you have been wonderful, so thank you so much for helping us and for being so understanding with this whole situation. If you know things go this way, I'm sure everybody will be safe, all of us will be safe, and we will continue seeing each other every week. Is that what we want, no?
Yes.
We want to see each other every week, so thank
Father,
you so
I think
much.
It's the safest place we can be.
Yes.
You know, there's no place safer than we are right now.
Yes, with the Lord. So thank you so much, everybody. God bless you. And as I said, we continue praying for each other, and especially for all those who are at home for different reasons. So we continue united in heart and in prayer. So God bless us, and God bless this beautiful parish family, Santa Ana. The Lord be with you. Let us bow our heads and pray for God's blessing. May the Lord, through the action of the Holy Spirit, bless you and keep you. Amen.
Amen.
May he let his face shine upon you and so show you his mercy. Amen. And may through the action of the Holy Spirit, may he turn his countenance towards you and give you his eternal peace. Amen. And may Almighty God bless you and your families, the Father, the Son, in the Holy Spirit. Amen.
And go in peace. The Mass has ended.
Have a blessed day, everybody.
Please
don't forget to smile. Okay? Even though people don't see you, you're smiling.